Hello everyone, myself Professor Tushar Gujarati, and today we are going to study the superposition of multiple inputs. Okay, while solving block diagram reduction problems, so many types multiple inputs are provided at one point, so we have to use superposition of multiple inputs rule over here. So we'll study this now. So what are the rules or steps while solving such a problem? So first step is set all inputs except 1 equal to 0. So set all inputs except 1 equal to 0. Second step, transform the block diagram to canonical form using the transformations of section 7.5 that we already studied in previous videos. Next, step number 3, calculate the response due to chosen input acting alone. So we have to calculate the response due to chosen input acting alone, okay? Next, step number 4, repeat steps 1, 2, 3 for each of the remaining inputs. And last step, algebraically add all of the responses determined in steps 1 to 4. This sum is the total output of the system with all inputs acting simultaneously. So actually we will try to understand this with the help of problem. So one problem is shown here, multiple input system. So determine the output C due to inputs R and U using superposition method. So in this case there are two inputs, one is provided here R and one is here U, okay? So there are two inputs and we have to solve this diagram. So we'll go one by one. So step one is put U is equal to 0, then system reduces to, the system gets reduced to something like this. So G1 and G2 are in series, that's why we can multiply G1 and G2, okay? And we can solve again this feedback loop, and then we get output as a ratio, that is CR upon R is equal to, we'll get some answer. That's why CR is equal to this answer into R, okay? So like this we'll get answer due to R, okay? Now in the next step, put R is equal to 0, okay, and put minus 1 into a block representing negative feedback effect. Okay, now we have put R equal to 0, but we have to add here minus 1 in this block, okay, representing the negative feedback loop or negative feedback effect. Now we have to solve this. Now we have to rearrange the block diagram. Now while rearranging, what you have to do, we have to just rotate this block diagram properly, okay? So what happens, this G1 and minus 1 are in one loop, okay, like this, so that way those we have written in series, and G2 is in another loop, that's why we have written G2 over here, okay? So like this block diagram gets reduced. Let the minus 1 block be absorbed into the summing point. So minus 1 can be absorbed in the summing point, so that's why it will change. So this minus 1 changes over here, plus sign gets negative over here, okay? Now you can solve very easily again. So here final answer is the output, you can solve, that is CV upon U. So CV is equal to G2 upon 1 plus G1 G2 into U, okay? So like this you will get answer due to input U. And finally the total output is addition of CR plus CU. So both the terms are added together and you will get the final answer like this. Now again we'll take one more example. So here in this case there are three inputs, R, U1 and U2. You can check here, this is R is one input, U1 is one input and U2 is one input. So like this there are three inputs, so we have to take these three inputs separately, okay? So let U1, U2 is equal to 0. We'll assume that only R is working. So at that time the diagram gets simplified as G1 into G2 divided by H1 into H2. Now simplify this block and we'll get answer as CR is equal to G1, G2 divided by 1 by G1, G2, H1, H2 multiplied by R. Okay. This is the output because of R, where CR is the output due to R acting alone, when R is acting alone, we will get this output. Now similarly, let R and U2 is equal to 0. Okay, so suppose only U1 is working. So now we have to rotate this diagram again. So rearranging the blocks, we get G2 divided by G1, H1, H4. Because these two blocks are in series, so we have written in series. And U1 is input here, NG2. Okay, so after solving this, we get answer as C1 is equal to G2 divided by 1 minus G1, G2, H1, H2 and multiplied by U1. So when we calculate output, then we have to multiply this transfer function by this input. Okay, so for output, you have to multiply transfer function by input. So you remember this actually, na? So here transfer function, we got this entire term multiplied by U1. Okay, so like this you remember. So that's our final answer is C1 is equal to G2 divided by 1 minus G1 to H1 H2 into U1. So where C1 is the response due to U1 is acting alone. Okay. Now finally let R U1 equal to 0. Now we'll assume that U2 is only working. Okay. Now in this diagram, these two are in series. Okay. So we have to write in series. So suppose U2 is working, then G1, G2, H1 are in forward path and H2 is in feedback path. Okay. Now we have to solve this feedback loop and we will get this answer. Answer for C2. So where C2 is the response due to U2 is acting alone. When U2 is acting alone, we will get this response. By superposition, the total output is, we have to add all the three outputs due to CR, C1 and C2. So we will get this final answer. So like this you can solve the problems. Now here one more example is shown. Now in this example, determine C1 and C2 due to R1 and R2. So there are two outputs, C1 and C2. Then we have to calculate because of R1 and R2. So we will solve this step by step. Now what is first step? First ignoring the output C2. We will ignore the output C2 first of all. And then we will write down the terms. R1 as it is, plus minus as it is. Then G1 will write as it is. G3 and G4 will be in series and G2 will remain again different. Okay, like this we can rearrange the terms. Then let R2 is equal to 0 and combining the summing points. Then the simplification is like this and we'll get output for C11. The output at C1 due to R1 alone is C11 is equal to G1 upon R1 divided by 1 minus G1, G2, G3, G4. Okay. Now suppose R1 is equal to 0. Okay. So you will get some answer something like this. So this is the C12 is the answer for R1 is equal to 0. So like this you will get answer and you have to add both the answers together, C11 and C12, so that you will get final answer for C1. Now we reduce the original block diagram ignoring output C1. Now we are ignoring here output C1, we will find C2. So block diagram will get reduced something like this. Now in this case also we have to put R1 equal to 0, only one input R2 is working. The diagram will be something like this and we'll get answer for R2, that is C22. We have written here answer as C22. This is our answer. When R2 is equal to 0, the diagram will get simplified something like this and we get answer as C21. Okay, like this. And finally we get total answer as C2 is equal to C21 plus C22. This is our final answer. So like this we can solve the problems of multiple inputs. Now this is the skill assessment exercise. Now you try to solve this exercise at your home and write down the answer in comment box. Okay, so answer should be something like this, and you try to achieve this answer and write down the answer in comment box whether you understood or not, yes or no. So thank you so much all of you for watching this video. Thank you so much.